Hi everyone, this is Natasha. I wanted to show you how I color in some of my stamped images. I received this stamp. It's the strawberries from StampersBest. There you go. And I stamped them out on American Crafts white cardstock. There's a layer of my favorite black cover stock, and it's on American Crafts little note card. So what I wanted to do is for those girls who attended, who came to the meet and greet yesterday, I wanted to give them a little note, a little something, something. So I stamped this berry image and I'm going to color it in, but I'm going to color it in like this. And I'm going to show you how I do it just using three different products. No blending, really, really easy. And on my computer, I'm going to print off a little... Well, I don't know. I haven't decided. Maybe I'll do my Dymo labeler saying, "Barry, nice to meet you." I know it's a little hokey, but it's kind of cute. So that's the image that has already been colored in. Wonder why my autofocus is having a field day. Focus, please. There you go. So the first thing I'm going to do is the two of the pens that I picked up yesterday is this Jelly Roll from Sakura, and it's Red Star, I think. Yeah, Red Star, and a Glaze from Sakura in Olive Green. And what I'm going to do, since I've already adhered these, I stamped them with Memento and this chalk writer that I'm going to use for the stem. So I'm going to do the stem first in the thinner. And I'm just going to go over the stems because I don't want them to, otherwise if I don't use a different color, there's a lot of green in the image. So I'm just trying to make a slight distinction between the stems. You can see right there. I'll leave that on my board so you could see it. And when you're not coloring for shading, like with Copics, it goes really quickly. So the first thing I'm going to use is this Jelly Roll by Sakura, and it's Red Star. And if you don't have access to these, you could certainly use any glitter pen. And I'm just going to go over the strawberries. Because this has a lot of shimmer, but it's not opaque, you could still see the berry seeds, plus it's a lot of shimmer. And the leaves are shiny. The effect, I think, is getting lost a little bit on camera. It's really quite lovely. So I'm going to do this first because the leaves are going to be done with the glaze pen, and the glaze pen does need to set up so it would be liquidy. So I want to do the one that is not liquidy. And there's no fancy schmancy thing to do. It's just coloring. And I'm going to cover the entire surface initially, leaving little leaves white for now. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to give some greater impression around the outside periphery of each of the strawberries to give it a look of a little depth. Again, there's a little strawberry here and this little strawberry. And it's a really sweet image. And I think it would be appropriate for any number of things. Imagine you need to include something sweet with a little, you know, a little card. Or if you've made some preserves, you could totally have a whole bunch of these all made up, ready to go, which is going to be my intent. And then I can just add whatever image or whatever sentiment I need to on this little space right here, and then write my personal note on the inside. As you can see, this goes pretty quickly, and the shining element of the Red Star pen is just incredibly vivid, and it's not covering up entirely all of the little seeds. So you could still tell that it's a strawberry rather than a blob of red. So what I'm doing now is just adding a few more lines around the bottom of each of the strawberries. And you'll see once it dries just a little more, you'll see that there is a little distinction. You could wait and do this later once it's already set up. That's it. That couldn't be any easier. And I'm going to go in with the glaze pen, and you'll see how quickly this goes on. It comes out liquidy, but you have great control over it because it's fine tip. I'm just going to move my card around because I've already attached everything. And once I color it in, I'll bring it up closer to the camera so you could see just how liquidy it goes on. And when it dries, it's got this built-in like gloss. It's really quite a lovely effect. Now, I know that there are sets of glaze pens because I have a set as well, but I don't believe that the standard set has this particular color in it. Just gonna turn this around. I'm trying to keep the pen moving and keeping my hand off the paper where I've gone over and added this liquidier part. And this goes really quickly. These do need to air dry. You should not be heat setting them because it changes the gloss aspect. And I'm nearly done. And I hear my husband coming down the stairs. Hopefully he'll figure out that I'm on video. So I have this.
Gosh.
Almost done. You can see it really comes together pretty quickly, and the effect is really cool. And you didn't have to do anything fancy, you just have to stay inside the lines. Almost done, last leaf. And actually, to make it even easier, if you could have stamped and embossed this in ultra fine black embossing powder, it would have made this filling in even easier. You wouldn't even have to worry about staying within the lines, which shouldn't be too much of a problem for most people. So there you go. You see all that super shine? And let me just close my pen because I don't want it to dry out. And this one is already dry. See? Completely dry, but the effect is really cool. So there's that card. That was that quick. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to decide whether I want to print off the message on my computer or if I want to do a Dymo labeler saying, very nice to meet you. And I'm going to send these off to the girls who were so sweet to come and meet me in person yesterday at Inspiration Station. And if anybody's interested, I will include a link to this stamp from Stampers Best in the description below, as well as some close-up photographs of this card on my blog. So all we did is use three markers and one stamp, and the impact is just very, very pretty. If you have any questions for me, please leave me a comment. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching.